Are you a, like, popcorn eater when you get to the movies? You get the butter popcorn and all that?
No, I don't get the butter. I don't get the butter, but...
Oh, that's so good.
I don't know if it happens to you, too, but do you guys eat the popcorn before the movie starts?
Yeah.
It's really annoying. You, like, get to the movie and, like...
And the problem is, if you go to the matinee, then you don't eat for like 2 days because you have 14 pounds of popcorn.
Pretty much. That's a bad thing.
Talk about this place.
Oh, well, Barber's a lot of fun. It's, I think it's really challenging for us drivers because you really drive the car at the limit. You know, you go through turn one and you're just lifting a little bit and it's really sketchy out there. But it's a lot of fun, like a giant roller coaster, and every lap you do, you know, you just have a huge smile because it's so much fun to drive around.
I noticed this coming in. I came in through turns 10 and 11 over there. And there's the ants with the driver. Did you ever have a caution lap, like driving around, like, oh my god, there's a driver? Did you ever look around?
No, you see the spider really? Right. You don't really see the ants right back there. But it is a little weird, especially having a driver hanging out with them. It's like, it doesn't really make sense. But it's pretty cool to have all these different kind of arts around the racetrack, and it's a beautiful place. Like, I don't think there's any racetrack here in North America or even in Europe that is so nice. You know, everything is well prepared, and it's really fun to come here every year.
It really is a lot of fun. The change in the size of the fuel cell, we're down to 18.5 gallons. Will this cause it? It didn't really seem to make a difference in St. Pete. As far as strategy, does that make a difference? Do you think you guys are going to have to do an extra stop this year?
I think so. Well, pretty much everything we've looked at is going to be pre-stopper. You know, I think the window is pretty small to get you into your pits. I think it's only like, 8 to 10 laps. So, we'll see. I think there's going to be for sure pre-stop because we're counting. If we wanted to do two, we needed like 25 caution laps, which, like, doesn't happen here, so it'll be three stops for sure.
You guys come in early, you start 21st.
Yeah.
Is that something that you get out of the same place so you get clean track, or?
I think, you know, it's something we really have to consider right now, because right now we don't have the speed that we want to have, so going off strategy is going to be our best bet, and I think that's really what we're going to try. You know, we'll see how it plans out at the start, but it is a big consideration to do that.
You guys believe on this team. Obviously, you got the engine late, and you had to go down the test. They're behind, and it's because everything happens so late, the engine's behind. As a driver, you know you're confident, you're a great driver. You did so well in St. Pete last year, the first half of the season until the accident was amazing. How do you temper yourself as a driver to know it's maybe not going to happen for a while until we get this engine developed? Do you still attack it the same way, or do you have to rethink how you approach the race?
Well, it is a little bit challenging as a driver, because as a driver, you know, we want to go out there and get every race, and but in this situation we're in right now, you have to help, you know, Lotus and John to develop the engine, and those are, you know, they can be a little bit annoying, but on the other side, we learn so much from it that as a driver, you know, even to start the season is tough. But I think it's just going to make me better in the long run because I'm going to have to go through this. And, you know, every week we're making improvements, we're able to pretty quick. And so we just have to keep working at it. And, you know, it's going to take a little bit of time, it's going to take a couple of races till we're really competitive. But I think we just have to be really focused on it. And, you know, it is sometimes a little bit frustrating, but you just have to deal with it. And, you know, I'm lucky to be in the IndyCar Series, and this is my chance right now. This is what I have, and, you know, I just have to do the best out of it. And, you know, I hope we'll improve from last weekend.
You really had it was one of those storybook seasons last year, the things that you had to overcome. And your team manager, Rich Kramer, is now running the Cars Run Indy Lights series. So the dynamics of that team has changed a little bit. For the better, for the worse, is it a tough challenge to get used to a new dynamic for the team?
Yes, so we've changed quite a bit in the team. Actually, the funny thing is most of the people on the team right now used to be my team that had an Atlantics and almost won the championship. So, you know, we hired a lot of good people that I have a lot of confidence in, and also my engineers. So I think it's good for me because they know what I can do in a race car. So there's no doubt about what I'm saying and my feedback. So we're just really trying to work together and trying to figure out this new car. And it's been going pretty well. You know, I think we haven't learn a couple of things with this because we haven't tried on the race car yet. You know, with the old car, it was easy because you had this window where you know the car was quick and what is needed. And this year, we have to find this window. So that's what we're doing right now. And yeah, you know, team manager changed. Pretty much a lot of people changed. But I think we have a really strong group. And, you know, it's you guys are working so hard, you know, to get everything ready. Even, you know, for Annette, it must be frustrating too when we qualify like 20th. But, you know, they're working as hard as we would be in P1. And, you know, I think that's motivating everybody in the team. And, you know, we're just going to push really hard every time we go on the racetrack.